animals can also play a role in making nursing homes more home-like for residents. There are a wide range of animals that have been used as visiting companions, on-site companions, and used as part of therapeutic activities for residents. For many people in aged care who may not be able to keep their own animal, interactions with visiting or on-site animals are very important. All of these environmental enrichment principles can help with good mental health in the nursing home. This area of psychological environments is a growing area within psychology for all ages, not just older adults. This is Paro the Seal. Paro the Seal was developed in Japan. It's an assistive device for people in nursing homes. It's meant to be cognitively stimulating and also just fun to interact with. They cost about $5,000 US each. They're very high tech because they have all these measuring devices in them that show how much the older people pat them and otherwise interact with them. You might ask, why did they make a seal? That was my first question. Why? Who would want a seal as a pet? But the seal has big eyes. It's very simple. It's all one color. It's not a dog or a cat, so you have to interact with it in a slightly different way. Paro is very interactive. If you pet it on the head, it goes, ow, ow, ow. If you whack it, it goes, arr, like that. It makes a very sad noise. It's very engaging. What I liked about it is it's not to fool older people. Sometimes people think you're just fooling the older people with dementia into believing this seal is real. I've seen many video clips. If you go to YouTube and search for Paro the Seal, there's tons of YouTube videos. In this one retirement community, they had a bunch of Paro seals. It was amusing because the older Japanese women were petting Paro, and all the older Japanese men were trying to take it apart to see how it works. Everyone knew it was not real, but it was something different, something engaging.